worldwide, we kill 2.7 trillion animals every single year, and that's for food, clothing, and entertainment. 90% of that death comes from food. So by becoming vegan and by no longer purchasing these products, we can spare 2.7 trillion animals from going through this every single year. I mean, there's only 7 billion humans, and the number of 2.7 trillion is almost unimaginable. We've never seen a number that big before. So the question is, what do you stand for? And the team behind me and myself, we stand for animal liberation. So no animals in cages, animals no longer used. Currently we're showing footage in all the ways in which we use animals, which is for animal testing, for food, for clothing, for entertainment. And all these reasons are unnecessary in 2019. So we're engaging with the public, showing them the reality of what it looks like for the animals. And we're talking to those people who choose to stop and watch what we're doing. For those who consider what we're showing to be evil, to be wrong, to be disgusting, we can talk to them about how we can end this from happening. The only reason these animals go through these experiences is because we keep demanding it with our choices. Every time we buy these products, the farmers, the suppliers, whoever it may be, they produce more animals. They breed more animals into existence, and then more animals have to go through this. So to end this, to free and liberate all animals, we just simply need to stop consuming it. So we're all aware that animals suffer. We're all aware that animals feel pain. And because of that, often we're very hesitant about what we buy. So companies will use labels to convince us that what we're doing is okay. They'll use labels like free range. They'll use labels like organic. Or, you know, these words that we hear all the time, humane. Humane is a really big one. We often hear the word humane when discussing slaughter. If we just use the word slaughter, everyone knows it's not humane. But as soon as they put humane in front of it, it makes us feel at ease. So what we're doing is we're showing the reality of what humane looks like. Because when people see that, once they see the truth, they often no longer wish to contribute to it. It's just a lack of knowledge and lack of information. Once they're exposed to the information, hopefully, and in many cases, they do make different choices. We can end it by simply purchasing different products. And it's so easy in 2019. We've got vegan food everywhere. We've got vegan clothes everywhere. We've got vegan leather. We've got vegan makeup. Products that aren't tested on animals. So there's so much choice. It's so easy. This isn't just a product on a shelf. This is part of a body of a sentient being that didn't want to die. Every single animal has a desire to live. None of them would ever choose death. That we force this upon them every time we go to a shop and make a simple purchase choice. The arguments that we hear can take many forms. However, they just basically come down to tradition, habit, and ease of choice. It's what they're familiar with, it's what they've been used to. Tradition, I mean, traditionally we didn't give women rights. We didn't allow certain people the right to vote. We enslaved human beings. We recognize these things as wrong. Even though we did them for hundreds of years, we recognized them as wrong and we changed it. And this is now something that is exactly the same. It's wrong to use animals. Animals don't wish to be used, they have their own desires. We don't choose to use cats and dogs. And what's different between a dog and a cow, or a dog and a pig? They're almost as intelligent as one another, and in the case of pigs, they're more intelligent than dogs. They have friends, they have families, they have a desire to raise their children, but yet we take all of that freedom away from them every time we choose to purchase these products. Other excuses we hear in terms of health. Lots of people think that we need to eat animals to be healthy, or it's just something they've never thought about before. They've been told that and they've never questioned it. But when you think about it, where do the animals get their protein from? Where do the animals get their iron and calcium from? They don't produce these nutrients, they consume them from plants, and then we consume them. And we can just cut out that part of the chain and we can go straight to the main source. When we become vegan, not only do the animals benefit, but we benefit. Our health benefits, the environment around us benefits. We have bluer oceans, we have greener rainforests. But most importantly, our conscience is now guilt-free. We know that this isn't on our conscience. We can enjoy meals comfortably knowing that animals didn't unnecessarily suffer for a sandwich. We can enjoy so many fruits and flavors, so many colors, but this behind us is something that we no longer pay for. So the best thing that you can do by becoming, or the largest benefit you have of becoming vegan is a guilt-free conscience.